My name is Avlak. I'm a senior user experience lead working at Peloton. I'm going to talk about the next generation computing on augmented reality, virtual reality, and mixed reality. Along with the talk, we have super exciting development. Yes. Okay. So let's start with augmented reality. Before I start, let me ask how many of you have played in Pokemon Go? Please raise your hand. Okay, now that's right. So Pokemon Go is a very simple example of augmented reality. In short, in augmented reality, you place your digital objects on top of real world that has both computer-generated sensory, like geodata, camera feed, or any other sensor. In the case of Pokemon Go, let's imagine like if you actually load the app in your phone and you start exploring your neighborhood.
Please don't move the chairs. Can't hear.
Now, let's talk about Pokemon Go for a minute. Imagine you load the app in your phone and you start exploring your neighborhood. When you reach a specific location, your Pokemon character gets triggered in your phone and you start playing the game. So let me say that again. When you start exploring your neighborhood and when you reach a specific geolocation, Pokemon character gets triggered in the game and you start playing the game. In that specific scenario, your geolocation is a target for that AR-enabled app. Now, for any augmented reality application, the target is the key. Target is the key to give you a better user experience for an AR-enabled app. Just like what I've explained, you Pokemon Go, you go to a location, you get a character there. And when you move to another location, you won't see the character. Now, talking about targets, targets are not just about any geo-coordinates. It can even be an image target, or it can even be a 3D object, 3D object of any size and scale. Now, let me stop the theory and just come to the demo so we can easily visualize and picturize how this works. Imagine you want to build a home. You meet an architect. You tell your dream. And the architect says, okay, come back after 2 weeks. And when you reach the architect after 2 weeks, he actually gives you something like this. Okay? He actually gives you a plan, something like this. This is a 2D view. Then we start drawing our imagination on how the room looks like, how we arrange the room, and we even that have doubts like how the stair goes, how the window looks like, how even our bedroom looks like. We have lots and lots of doubts. And we try to draw that from this simple 2D image. Now, imagine if this has been visualized as a 3D visual to the client or the customer so that he can easily get the idea of what we are going to present. But just really give them all that. Let me explain the setup a little bit. I have an AR-powered app in my phone. And I'm going to use an AR-enabled app to visualize the 3D visualization from a 2D image. And the demos that we're going to cover right now is based on an image target. So moments before we talk about geo targets. Geo targets is for Pokemon Go or some other game like that. In this case, I'm going to talk about image targets. Idea of image target is you set an image as a target, and whenever that image comes to the view, and a trigger, an event is triggered, and based on that event, you can actually place 3D objects on top of that image target. Okay, now you can see my screen of my Android device, and to the left, you can see a promise of AR. This is an AR in the lab. Now, I'm going to launch that app. From a real perspective, this app is actually built using Unity. The Unity is very helpful. You might have heard about it. Now, the advantage of creating a Unity app, if you are targeting Unity platform, is that you can develop those platforms. I originally built the code, built the app in the code on my desktop. So when I was coming on the page of the event, I just retargeted to Android, just created a Unity app. That's all. So that's the advantage you get when you actually use the platform in English. Now, okay, the same screen. So this was what we were talking about. So this is a tool that you usually get. from your armchair. Let's look at this. Let's look at it. Okay, I displace it. You can see you. Okay? Now I can move around. Okay? I can even see my bedroom. I can even see my bedroom. Okay, look, that's it up. And I can see the dining hall. Okay? Now let me just like, oh, okay. Now that's a kitchen. You can actually see it there. And the motor is kitchen. You can see an office. You can see the living area.
What's an elephant?
how does the end looks like? What sound does it make?
So, now, this is a problem with that. You can actually comment on the neighborhood, but elephants are not free of them.
And in that case, you can actually use general case target or something like that. Let's look at that. Okay, see that? Now this is how you can leverage augmented reality for your applications. Okay, you can even add interactions like that, just as one could, so that it makes some noise. Okay, but I hope you just get the idea. So this is in a very simple capsule size of augmented reality. Okay. Now, don't get blind, also blinded by the fact that only image target works. It can even detect any object. That is a 3D object, or even a cylinder like this. This is a pen holder. This is a pen holder. Just watch it carefully. If you bring closer here, you can see a candle. Now, this is a 3D object. I actually break after detecting a cylinder. Oh, is it? This is a very, in a very nutshell, how open reality and how you can leverage that to different areas, whether it's engineering, product visualization, whether it's education. Now that's all about open reality. Let's switch to virtual reality. So now we have seen different part of the image, cylinder object. Let's switch to virtual reality. Now, in virtual reality, theoretically it says a realistic and immersive 3D environment created with the help of software and computer, where interactions is made by movement of your body. That's the theory. And how many can try to record for an HTC Vive? Okay, that's the good number. Great. Good. So you had a chance to experience how this looks like. Now, in a virtual reality, the fully immersive mode is possible with the help of a virtual reality headset. Virtual reality headsets are nothing but head-mounted goggles, which has a screen in front of you. It can either be a smartphone or it can be an independent screen, in the case of Oculus Rift and HTC Vive. Now, the experience can be roughly similar to how you watch a 360 degree video, where you have a video rendering there. And you can interact with the video, hang around with your mouse, you can move down, move it up, move left, move it down, and many more interactions. So it can be connected roughly similar to that. And since in virtual reality, you can't see your real world, you need to use external controls to interact with the objects in your immersive world. Something like this. Okay. Because you then, once you get the VR view, you are totally blind. You can't see anything. What's in front of you? You can't even see the person is sitting next to you. You can't even get from the couch, get from the chair, and move around or whatever. So in that case, you are truly immersive, and to interact with any object in the immersive world, you need to use an external hardware. Now, how the VR kit actually does is that it splits the screen into two. One screen for each of your eyes. Something like this. Okay. look at it, this screen just actually split. And one lens for your eyes, the other lens for your other eyes. Okay, but when you wear the headset, this line will be blurred, and you will feel that it's a complete picture. Okay. Now this is done by applying a barrel distortion to create a stereoscopic 3D, something similar like this. Now I'll show you a very good demo of that. Now I have an app called Vithen. This is available in Play Store. There is a video called Equation, a minimum problem. Now, I assume you might have received the VR kits by this video. You can actually try out these videos with the VR kit provided. Experience is like you are completely immersed in a 3D environment, which is purely computer generated. Okay. And you can interact with moving your body. But it doesn't mean that you can get up on the chair and walk. You can just move there and move. And use external controls to interact. Now let's move to the most exciting Now, so this is what I'm talking about. You wear it, it's a external control system right to cover it. And this is your experience. That you when you wear it. This is a view that you have seen just by sharing this screen. Find the view with me. You are playing in the other. When you hear it, you are actually blocked from your mirror. The humans living in the mirror experience life in three dimensions. We hear, we interact, and we walk around in three dimensions. And our brain starts even in the mirror. What if the apps that you create exist in our real world, coexist in our real world, and you can interact with your app truly, naturally, just like you interact with any objects in the real world. Imagine the world becomes a canvas itself, and how you are going to unleash your creativity that you're not creating. Okay. Do we have the only this drop, I mean, that white point is actually called case. The similar thing what happens in universal reality. And gaze is always conformity. Just like I don't want to do some interaction, I just move the gaze to an object, then I will start an interaction. Now, I told you that this is a Windows 10 PC, and every Windows 10 device comes with a start screen. And this device is also having a start. And for triggering it, I have just a code bloom. Bloom means the how the flower blooms like this. So this isn't just a program. I'm just going to bloom. Okay. I go to my start screen. Okay. I can see all the apps. I can see a Microsoft app, settings, photos, store, programs, feedback hub, learn, test recipe. I even have a plus. This is in the pure code programs in the desktop. To select an object, I have a gesture code here, and something like this. This is the way we actually pick an object in the real world. For the digital world, I use it as gesture code tab. I'm just looking at the plus and then tab. Okay. I get a list of devices, sorry, list of apps installed in my phone. Okay. Now, when I was conducting an OLS in past month, somebody asked me, do I ever feel like story start with a Jarvis coming to it? Just because I tell it's a Windows 10 PC, I have Cortana integrated with it. I can even say, hey Cortana, sing a song.
Yes, I missed a very important point. In the case of VR,
for example, HTC Vive or Oculus Rift, you have a long wire connecting from the device to your laptop. Because major computing is being done on the laptop. In this case, the computing itself is done within the device.
The connection was Wi-Fi?
No, Wi-Fi connection that was just for accessing the web portal. It has a web portal built into it to how we can manage the device. You just go, you will get a set of options enabling stream, what it will see, install apps, remove apps, and think of it as a control panel. That's
for the device. Wi-Fi or Bluetooth?
So mixed reality, merging of real and the virtual world, and your digital objects coexist in your not just a real and virtual world. Your digital objects coexist in your real world. They're very similar. Now, Wi-Fi HoloLens, it is untethered. Those things are attached. Every computing happens in the device, and it's a Windows 10 PC with Intel Atom chip. It's much powerful than your average laptop. Now, another important feature is spatial understanding. It understands your world, it understands the map. Easily understands what objects are in front of you. When I say objects, it's, you don't recognize it as table, but it gives you information that as planes and vertical planes, horizontal planes. It gives information that to you like that, and that's how you manage it. Then it has inside of gravity. Now, talking about inside of gravity, imagine that you are wearing a device that it understands your 3D view. Now, when you move from one location to another within the 3D map, it needs to update your location. That within the 3D map that you constructed, it needs to remap, like saying that, okay, now you have moved from this place to this place. It's called inside of gravity. And that is also being done without no sensors attached. All sensors are within the device. In the case of HTC Vive, you need to place sensors at the corners of your room to understand whether you are moving closer or not. In the case of HoloLens, inside of gravity is built. Now, interactions in action. Very common interactions are these, the way you gesture, this one here, and it has voice interaction. Now, two comparison of augmented reality, virtual reality, and mixed reality. Now, mixed reality opens the real world with cultural information. Just like we have seen, I have pinned the start button, settings will look here. Now, blend holograms in the real world. So, you understand this is a world and the settings have a certain place on the board, it understands the board, can transport your virtual world, you remember that. But it will never replace your board. So, what's inside? It's a masterpiece of sensor fusion. It has touch sensors, RGB cameras, and many other sensors. And that's how it's capable to capture the environment and do the spatial mapping and inside of that. Then it has advanced optics. It has an HD lens, where all the digital photograms are projected within the device. And it's a high quality, low latency. Next, it has a custom HD. Think of it as a GPU. When we talk about desktop PC, you have a dedicated GPU for rendering the graphics. Similarly, this device, it has an HD called photographic processing unit. All the world, all the mapping, all the holograms rendering, all the heavy lifting groups are done by this custom. And that is done in real time. Okay, now this is a very example of how it sees a room. This is a green color, but this is for desktop illustration. Now let's come back to that. Now this is actually a web portal which is built right into the device. Every device once connected to the electronic panel, which can go into the device and do the device management. Now I'm going to start the live view. Now we'll just start with a very hello world. Hello world is a standard coding program. Start with a hello world. Now, this is a very simple demo. Let's move to the company in front of me. Yeah, of course, this is actually very easy. The advantage of using Unity is that it comes with VR and MR built in. Now, you can see a view, right in the room, right? Now, this is a view. It's a very simple view. Think of that for 30 feet. Again, walk around the view. It just lives in your brain. Can you even look underneath it? Now, this is what I meant by saying. Your digital objects coexist in the real world. Now, imagine when you take this to product and place it in engineering construction mode. If you take it, then see it in the real world. And now, this is very important. Let me just close it. Now, just like any app, it has a close button. Just going to remove it, remove the handle. Okay, you can see the settings up here. I just did it. Okay. It understands your work and it is staying here. Okay. Now, is it a cool demo?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, let's go to Japanese. Yeah, the bottom is out and few birds flying up. You can even see a red. My case over there, so you can see where I'm looking at. Okay, so just see whether you can see our board if we send. Oh, okay, they look at that. You can see the whiteboard if we send moments before. Okay, now I open up another board within this board. And let's send. Let's send your other board also. This is about product visualization. Now, there are people who are actually interested in data. People will be having a huge scoring of them. How they are going to leverage this device to have a data interesting. That is also interesting. And for that, we actually created an app called HoloFlight, and I'll show you that. So what an app does is it actually puts the data on the airline and maps how you pay is actually traveling between the islands. Let me see.
And
and etc. For engineering and training. And you can also do such a test here, where you're adding companion apps, you are doing a mnemonic set. You can add in particular to your engineering, you can take that, which is done around the problem, there was a problem with the human part. Now, this is what we have here, part of design and personal. Now, for the developers, I start with a quick slide. This is not a complete one. For augmented reality, you have a set of SDKs available. And for all the AI demos I have actually used Euphoria. This is which I told you the And for virtual reality, you have web VR platform, you have Bakery, Oculus, and Y. For mixed reality, which is what I have demonstrated, you can use Visual Studio and Unity. The reason why Unity is always a first class citizen for VR and MR is that it has all the SDKs baked right on the web. You build it, you retarget it, you put any platform. And two development nations leverage the uniqueness of the device. That's what we need to do. You can think outside the box and treat it as a mobile device. So think about how the battery is going to frame when you have a big computing device. And think about design for optimal frames, like for best frames. Think about the texture that you're going to add to 3D objects. And for some important things, and we're not really building, there are plugins and SDKs available. And offering is also an option, which means that when you have a computer, you can actually put the computing to the background service. So to, in the case of Oculus, you can do any of the computing back to the laptops. So offering is also an option. And that's an all from my side. And I told you it's an incredible time to be a developer. And thank you very much for listening. It's one of my